Hello everybody, this video is about polynomial regression using make pipeline in Jupyter Notebook. So as always, we need to load the data, and to load the data we need a pandas library. For pandas as pd, then we need to read the data itself. I name the data my data, the object equal pd dot writer underscore CSV code. The data is found in this folder. This is the name of the data discharge. So it's about river discharge. So I copy the directory and paste here. I double the code. I write discharge.csv. I double this backslash as well. Okay, the data is read. Let's write my data dot describes. You see, okay, this is what you have. As statistics and the quantiles as well. So we have a T for time, SM for soil moisture, ST for soil temperature, AT for air temperature, ET for evapotranspiration, SH for specific humidity, P for precipitation, D underscore BG is the river discharge at location BG. And the D underscore LG is the river discharge at the location LG. And we want soil moisture as the independent variable or input feature. And the river discharge at BG as the dependent variable or output feature. Let's try the correlation between them and see. Although correlation doesn't mean necessary causation. So I base my analysis on the correlation, which is SM, soil moisture, and discharge at location VG 0.81. Okay. So the next step is to prepare the input and the output features. Okay, to do that we need the library in NumPy. I'm posting NumPy library. So import NumPy as np. Okay, now let's provide the input feature. X, which is the predictor, called also regressor, also called independent variable. So capital X equal np dot array my data brackets, we need our SN. Solve moisture. I know it must be a 2D array. So to make it a 2D array, we need the function reshape. And the argument, I got minus 1 to 1. This argument gives us the 2D array. We run. And now let's see the shape or X. Our input feature. It tells us that you have 84 rows and 1 column. Okay, now we provide the output. The output feature Y. It's called also dependent variable. Variable or the target or regression. These are the different names for the output feature. So y equal np dot array my data, and we take discharge at location bd. So the output data may or may not be 2D array. So y dot shape. Okay, we have 84 observation. We know the observation here, the rows. So and we already know that the variable is y, which is the discharge at bg. Okay, now is the step to split the data into train and the test data. To do this, we need to import the function train underscore test underscore split from scalar dot model selection. Model underscore scalar dot model underscore selection. Import train underscore test underscore split. Once we have the function, we need now to split the data. Okay. So x train, x test, y train. Y test equal train underscore split underscore test underscore split. We have our input feature, I have our output feature, and we need to have the size of our test data. So I take 30%. The size of less test data set. So okay, train test split is not defined. Okay, I put capital T here. So lower T. Okay, that's fine now. So if you want to check the size of the speed data, we have xtrain.sheet. We have 58 observation column, which is SM. So it means that out of 84, you have 58 as strain, so the test is going to be 26. Next test. Yep. And yeah. If you do the same thing, it's for Y. It's going to be 26. Yep. 1D and voilà. Okay, so the next step is going to be fitting the model itself. To fit the model, we need to import some classes. Sorry. Fitting the multiple polynomial. Okay, so importing classes, we need basically three classes. The first is from scaler dot preprocessing, and we need to import polynomial features. We need also linear regression from sklearn.linearModel. sklearn.linearModel import linear regression. And the third one, we need the make pipeline from sklearn.pipeline. Okay. Sorry. We run. Now we are going to set the polynomial degrees. So how many degrees we need? So I'm going to take it up to 4. So let's have degrees equal 1, 2, 3, 4. Brackets. So we already have them, so we are going to initialize some objects. White train, right, and the white test spread to store the value of the predictions. y underscore train underscore trace and y underscore test underscore path. Or the predicted values, or the predicted river discharge values. Okay. So here, each row is a data point. Each column. Is a prediction from a polynomial of a specific degree. From a polynomial y underscore thing underscore head for n p dot zeros parentheses, sorry, we are going to have the length of x train. To store like the data point and the length of degrees okay. We'll do the same thing for y test and also np dot zeros. This time we'll have the length of x test and the length of degrees. Okay. Now we are going to look for the degrees. So for I, sorry, for I enumerate for I degree in enumerate degrees. So degree is each degree and enumerates in the 4 degrees you have. So we are going to make pipeline create feature. Create features and fit them. Fit them to linear modeling. Okay, so our model is going to be equal make pipeline parentheses polynomial feature parentheses degrees colon linear regression parentheses. So this is our model. We are going to fit it now. So model dot fit parentheses x train y train. Polynomial features. Okay, missing I here. Polynomial features. Okay, so the model is make underscore pipeline polynomial features. You have degrees and the linear regression. Okay, this is the fit and the model dot fits. We fit it on x train and y train. Can only concatenate list, not integer. Okay. Okay, sorry, I made a mistake here. I should put degree here instead of degrees because we need the i's within the degrees. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, so you are going to take each of them. Why is the mistake here? Okay, you see. I should close it here and I remove this parenthesis. Okay, great. So yes, we initialized this object in order to store the predicted values for the y-test, and then we looked, we have our degrees here 1, 2, 3, 4, so we look through each of them and we make prediction, and after making we create the model, we fit the model. Okay, this is the model we make it using make pipeline polynomial features for degree, each of the degrees, and using linear regression, and then we fit the model on x train and y train. So after fitting, we need to have predictions. On train and test data. In this case, we are going to store predicted values of each degree and corresponding columns. Let's have a white line right. Column and I. Okay. Equal model dot predict x train. And we are going to make it also on test data. Also all the rows, and the column. So the column is going to take the predicted values. And the prediction is made on the data set, which is stored in the rows. Equal model dot predict x test. Done. Okay. Now we need to make the visualization. For the visualization, we need to import matplot lib dot pyplot as plt. We need to have this function. We also need to import that's going to be from sklearn dot preprocessing import main max scaler. This is to scale. We are going especially to scale the y-axis. Yes, the y-axis. So we need the scaler, the log scaler. So now we are going to set the figure's size plt dot figure parentheses fit size equal let's take 16 and 8. Okay. So let's go on the train data. Let's create subplot. PLT dot subplot. Let's have 121. This code is to create the subplot. Okay, this is what you have as a subplot. Okay. The next step is to create a scatter plot. Scatter, plt.scatter. X train, Y train. That's the observed data. Okay, this is what we have. X train, Y train. Observe data. Now we are going to scale the y axis. PLT dot y scale. Parentheses. We are going to take the log. You see here, this is the actual data set, data point, sorry, here, 500 to 750, we have 0 to 2000, so we need the log of it on y-axis, so we have this, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3, okay. So this is to scaling the y-axis. Now we are going to put the title. plt.title parentheses quote train data. Title. So we run and we have train data's title here. So now we are going to loop. Through each degree of the degrees and create a scatter plot of the predicted values. So for I degree and enumerate degrees, plot plt dot scatter. Y-train thread. So here we need the Y-train and Y-train thread. So Y-train and the predicted values obtained on Y-train. and we have it was done on each data set and for each degree. We have a size probably let's say 12, and the label you have it as string, and you write degree. Okay, so this is the observe and the predicted. See the observe here, this is from X train Y train. Now we have Y train and the Y train predicted. Okay, and we need also to put the legend. So you are going to have plt.legend. Have locked. We are going to put it at upper left for the location. Okay, this is the legend for the degrees. So degree 1, degree 2, degree 3, we don't see anything. We see the predicted values on from the degree 4. So we have degree 4 here. So this is the distribution of the observe and the predicted for the polynomial of degree 4. So you are going to do the same thing for the test data. Data set. Basically, it's going to be the same thing. So we are going to have the subplot again. We create a subplot, plt.subplot, and have a 1, 2, 2. So this is the subplot for, let's say, 1 to 1. Again, the same. That work or not? Don't know. Okay, this is for the test train data, test data. So we are going to create the scatter plot, plt.scatter. Then it's going to be noun x test, y test. Creating scatter plot. This is what you have, distribution of the observed data, the actual data on the test data train. And we have the values, actual values here, so we need the two the scale, the y-axis. Using log, okay, we have the y-axis in log now. Then we need the title, plt dot title. We have test data. Ok, Okay, we have the title test data here. Okay. Now we are going to go through the same thing again for I degree and enemy rate degrees. We have a PLC dot scatter for the predicted valid on Y test now. Y test and the Y test edit. For each data point and each degree, you have the label. Label equal here, sorry. Okay, it's not done yet. Here. What is plate? Okay. I have a parenthesis here. Good. And then we need our legend. Now PLT dot legend same thing, we need to put it at the upper left. Okay, this is what we have. So, same thing for the train data, we don't have any predicted data point for the polynomial of degree 1, 2, 3, and we have from degree 4. So, at degree 4 we have. So, these are the visualizations on train and test data of the observed data and the predicted data. So the next step is to compare the R squares for the train and the test data. all the polynomial fits, so for all the degrees. Okay, we need to import sklearn. To do this, then we need to print. R square, values on print and test data sets R colon. Okay, and then this is the code that's going to let us see the R squares corresponding to each degree on test and train data. Four. Five. Degrees column. Let's write this object R square on train equal we need the round values. Scalar in that matrix. Scalar dot matrix. Dot R2 underscore score. Y train. White train cut. For each data point and each degree. Okay. And we have the same thing again here for test. Underscore on test equal round sklearn dot matrix dot R2 underscore score. We are going to have on y test and y test pad now. Underscore test, underscore test, underscore pad for all the data points. Sorry, colon. Each degree. Okay. the underscore here, sorry. We have a parenthesis here. 1, 2, and the close. Okay, this way. And then now we are going to print the R square values. Print this code polynomial. Degree. Curly bracket. This is the location for the polynomials. Yep. Colon train score equal. That's 0, 1. Now for the test scores will be 2, like columns, first column, second column, third column. And now test score equal, call the bracket 2. And we need the format, dot format, parenthesis, plus let me come back, the format, we have degrees, we have R square for train, and R square for test. Okay. So we need to close again. One more parenthesis here. Okay, this is what you have. So, polynomial degree, 1, 2, 3, 4, you have for this, text train, or text score, train score, sorry, you have this corresponding to each polynomial, and the test score corresponding to each polynomial, the values of R squares. So, as we see here, from degree 1, 2, 3, all the R squares are negative. Both train and test data. So when we reach the polynomial degree 4 here, on train score we have 70%, and on test score we have 68%. So they're very close. So that reflects exactly what we get in the visualization here. So from degree 1, 2, 3, the model doesn't perform very well. But when we get to degree of polynomial 4, we see the distribution, the pattern of observed and predicted data here. So you can see that the model is better at polynomial degree 4, and the R squares on test and train data are very close. So hopefully this video helped you, and thank you for watching.